Welcome to our YouTube channel. So today I am going to explain you how to create data age analysis by using Microsoft Access. Actually, this is a very easy method. So I'll explain you step by step. Please pay your attention to whole video to get good understanding. Before going to the video, please subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos like this. Okay, let's go to the video. So here, this is my sample database. So my database contains one table called debtors. So my debtor table contains four columns. They are debtor ID, debtor name, due date, and the amount due. So based on these details, to create this analysis report, I am going to create a query based on my debtor table. So go to create tab and click on the query design and select the data table. For this query, I am going to select all these table columns: data ID, data name, due date, and the amount due. So my first step is to calculate the overdue days. To calculate overdue days, here date diff function to calculate the overdue dates. So this is the first function I use to calculate days overdue. So I'm going to copy and paste this function to my query. Yes, so this will create new column called debtors overdue. This is the column I newly created inside my query. So the column name is days overdue. So this is the overdue amount in days. Now the first step is okay. So the second step is to calculate the current due. It means due current amount. So how can I calculate due current amount? Here the due current amount is days overdue. Is if the layers here days overdue, if the date overdue value is less than 1, then it is the due current amount. So I am going to copy and paste this function. So this will generate due current amount. So this is my newly created due current column. So I run the query, but none of the values comes to due current column because these all days overdue values are higher than 1. So if the days overdue is less than 1, then you can see due current amount in this column. Yeah, the third step is to get the due amount 1 to 30 days. To get the 1 to 30 days due amount, I use this function. So I am going to copy and paste function to my query. Then let's see. Yeah, these are the 1 to 30 days overdue amounts. In between 1 to 30 days overdue data values are like this. Now next step is 31 to 60 days. To get the 31 to 60 outstanding amounts, this is the function I use. So I'll copy and paste the function to my query. Yes, these two values are belongs to 31 to 60 days, 58,000 and 700,000. Now 1 to 30 days and 31 to 60 days are okay. So I have remaining another three conditions. So they are 61 to 90 days overdue amounts. So how to find 61 to 90 days overdue amounts. This is the function I use to calculate 61 to 90 days. So copy and paste. There you can see 61 to 90 days outstanding amounts. So that column is empty. Then the next one is 91 to 120 days outstanding balance. So this is the function I use to calculate 91 to 120 days outstanding account receivables. So just copy and paste this function also. Yes, 91 to 120 outstanding balance cannot be not there. 91 to 120. Then the final one is over 120 days outstanding. So this is the function I use to calculate over 120 days data outstandings. Just copy this function and paste. Okay, now let's run the query. Yeah, so these are the outstandings over more than 120 days. So this is how you can calculate data age analysis using Microsoft Access. Actually, this is very easy. So I will attach my sample database and notepad document. So please download the sample database and this notepad document. Then try to make your own data age analysis report. Okay, that is it for today. So again, please subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you very much for watching.